Professor of Foam here. Today we're going to bring you something a little bit different. Today we're going to be reviewing two different coolers that are commonly available at almost any big box store. These are two different classes of coolers, and we're going to be grading both of them based on their design and technology. So today we're going to be taking a look at both of these coolers. Now again, these are available at pretty much any big box store. And we have two different classes of coolers here. So right here, this is your common cooler. This might have been what you and your grandpa or your father took on fishing trips when you were a kid. This is probably the cooler that almost every person has laying around in the basement or the garage somewhere. And then over here, we have the new space age technology coolers. This is very comparable to some of the $400 or $500 coolers that we're all aware of are out on the market. So we want to pay attention to their design specifically and the technology that goes into them. So let's take a look at this one over here. Again, this is your common everyday cooler. Now the first thing I want to point out is if we look at the walls, we see how thin they are. Now there is insulation inside these walls. And if we look at the lid here, this is completely hollow. There's nothing inside here as far as insulation to help hold any cold inside, help keep heat out, nothing like that. And when we close this, there is a positive close and you get, you know, somewhat of a decent seal. And if we look at the bottom, there's some in there also. So obviously it's enclosed and everything and relatively airtight and somewhat of a water seal. But again, there's insulation on the side walls, nothing on the top, some in the bottom. Also, it's very light. It's a very lightweight cooler. This is what we've seen for years and years and decades. Like I said, we all probably have a cooler like this somewhere in the house or in the garage. So now let's jump over to this. Again, space age technology. And what I mean when I say that is simply that the insulation that's inside the cooler is a little bit different. This one has a little bit different. It's more of a denser, high R value foam, and there's a lot more of it. So, if we pop off these security latches so no bears get in, grizzly approved, and if we lean this one over, you can see how thick those walls are. It's a lot more space for insulation to keep whatever's inside cold and to keep that warm out. Now, if we look at this lid, already I can tell by lifting it much, much heavier, and this is solid. There's foam in there just like on the walls, and there's foam on the bottom as well. If we look at both of these coolers, obviously they're very different. Now let's address cost. This cooler is about $20, maybe a little less. This is $100. Obviously a different grade. Now, if we're looking at something like this, you know, obviously more expensive, what do you get for that? We've already pointed out that the design alone, you know, just because there's much more insulation on the walls and that there's any on the top and on the bottom, you're going to get the effectiveness, you know, doing what it's supposed to do. It's going to work a lot better for that, obviously. Now, what else do you get with that $100 price tag? Well, super heavy. So when we think of things like heavy duty, we usually think of value. It's going to last a long time. It's going to be durable. Again, they claim that a bear can't get in this thing. But let's look at some things you get with that as far as design. So there's this rubber gasket that goes all the way around, and this provides an absolute positive air seal, as well as a water seal. So this is crucially important when you're looking at stopping heat loss. So if we look at this one over here again, yes, it shuts securely and it's not gonna fly open, things aren't gonna come out, but air can get in and out. If you were to put a thermal camera on this, you just see cold air pouring out of this. Keep that in mind. So the design is very different over here. Obviously, there's a few other crazy simple amenities. So on the front, there's a bottle opener, necessity. You have these really cool handles. There's a water drain that's a really heavy duty screw-in plug. Different things like that. There's different amenities that come with this that make it, you know, a little bit more appealing. But again, it's those little touches that you do get. However, we really want to pay attention to what's inside the cooler. What I mean is inside the walls. So again, if we look at something like this, yes, it has, you know, a decent amount of insulation. We've gotten used to coolers like this and they do work. They do the job well enough. Something like this, you know, if you're going for a trip, something like that, you're gonna be gone for an extended period of time. That's when something of a different class can come into play. So they both have their roles, you know, trip to the beach, probably going to be fine. Weak in the woods, you'll probably want something like this. So keep that in mind. They're two different things for two different markets. Now, if we look at this again, and we see the space inside, right? So this is a 48 quart cooler. This is a 55 quart cooler. Obviously, you know, relatively close, but this is much bigger. It's crazy heavy, but relatively, these are going to be the same size capacity. And again, if we open this up and look inside, you can see for the size of the cooler, the actual capacity spot where you're going to be putting stuff is much, much smaller. That's a little bit deceiving to people, but that's important to note because you want those thick walls. You want this lid that's crazy insulated and sealed. You want that gasket at the top. You want the floor, the bottom of this, to be insulated as well. So it's a little bit, you know, a bit of a trade-off because you have this huge, bulky, heavy thing, but it can do the desired job much, much better if that's what you're looking for. So, just a quick simple review of these two different classes of coolers. You know, the common one that, you know, we all kind of have, we've used for a long time and does the job, frankly. You know, for $20, it's definitely worth its money. But if you need something to do the job better, longer, $100, hard to say it's not worth it. So now that we've taken a look at the design and technology that goes into both of these coolers, let's see if they get a passing grade. So first, let's take a look at this one. If we have to assign this a grade, we have to give it an A. If we look at the cost of this cooler and what it's intended for, it absolutely makes sense. This is really a cooler for the day trip to the beach, going to a family barbecue, taking some sodas or something like that. For what you're paying for it, this absolutely performs that task well. And it earns an A. Now, if we're looking at this cooler, obviously we're jumping way up in price, but again, the design and technology also very different. And we would have to give this cooler an A also because of the fact that you get all those extra amenities and it will perform its job even better. But again, this is intended for something a little bit different. This is intended for that person who's taking the 5-day excursion into the woods, that long hunting trip or that long road trip where you're going to be away from home for several days. This will do you well for that sort of task. I want to keep in mind also, this particular cooler gets a lot of extra credit. Why? Well, it's got foam absolutely everywhere from the top, the bottom, the walls, and it has an absolute air seal. So for those reasons, this is professor approved. So if you're watching this and your house is more like the red cooler, nothing in the top, bare minimum in the walls, maybe some in the bottom, then you really have some things to address. You should definitely contact a professional company like us to help you get your house sealed up. Hope this information was helpful to you guys. Please leave us a comment, ring that bell so you see all of our notifications. And if any of you want to buy a cooler half price, let me know.